Hello students, hope you are doing well. Welcome back to our economics class. Today we are going to start unit number 5, very short questions. From the 7 concepts which are written on the board, you are going to get any one very short concept in your intermediate public examination from unit number 5. So let us start with our first concept, that is market. So what do you mean by the term market? Let us see. So market refers to all the activities, of purchasing and selling wherever this take place, that certain place is termed as market. In simple terms, what is market meant? All the activities of purchasing and selling, either you are purchasing some commodity or you are selling some commodity. So a place where the activities, all the activities of purchasing and selling take place, that certain place is termed as market. Is that clear? Then the second concept is equilibrium price. Generally, equilibrium is a position which is termed as a balanced one, means either it's neither too high nor too less. It is constant, or you can say it is balanced. So here the concept of equilibrium price will play a very important role in economic analysis. Means while studying economics, while preparing policies and programs under economics, equilibrium price is such a concept which will play a very important role in economic analysis. Then this side, the term equilibrium price is that price where the demand and supply is equal in the market. That means it is that price, equilibrium price is that price where the demand and the supply is equal in the market. Whenever demand is equal to supply in that market, so such kind of price is called as equilibrium price. So once again, let us recall it. The concept of equilibrium price plays a very important role in economic analysis. Then the next thing, the term equilibrium price is that price where the demand and supply is equal in the market. So concept 1 and 2 is done. Let us go with the third one, that is oligopoly. The third concept is oligopoly. So oligopoly is a market where there are small number of producers. How many producers are there? Small number of producers are there. Each product may be homogeneous or it may be different. Homogeneous means same. The meaning of heterogeneous is which is different. So whatever the products oligopoly market are producing, that may be same or that may be different. So it is termed as it may be homogeneous, the product may be homogeneous or it may be different. So each firm will produce considerable part of output. As I said, there are only small number of producers, so they will produce only considerable part. That means they'll produce small part of output. Obviously, when large producers are there, they'll produce large. When small producers are there, they'll produce small. So each firm will produce considerable part of output. This market exists in automobiles, electricals, cigarettes, etc. Where do you find oligopoly market? In 3 types. The first is either you find in automobiles, you find in electricals or cigarettes, or many other examples are there. So in simple words, it is a market where small producers are there. Then fourth concept, duopoly. The word itself is saying duo means two. In this market, there are two producers. Both are aware of decision. Both are aware of decision, and the decision of one will affect the other. The two persons are there. So one person, whatever the decision he takes, automatically it will affect the other person also. And this side, you see, they make decision either independently or together. So whatever the producers are there in duopoly, the two producers, they will make the decision either together or they'll make it independently. Next concept is monopolistic competition. Several producers will produce same commodity with small differences. Means many producers will produce the same commodity but with small differences, and that advertisements will be taking place over here in order to promote the goods. Means the customers should be aware of your product. In order to make the customers aware of your product, we do advertisements in order to promote our goods. The next one, like you see many advertisements on your television, on internet, etc. So why do they do advertisements? In order to promote their goods. Sixth concept is product differentiation. Commodity of each producer will be different to other producers. Here I said the commodity will be same. Several producers will produce same commodity, but here the commodity of each producer will be different from each other. And how those differences will take place? The differences may be due to color, due to design, smell, packaging, etc. How the products are different? Either because of the color, because of the design, because of the smell, or because of the packaging, etc. So whatever the product they produce, it will be different from other producers. Next, last concept is selling cost. Every producer will make expenditure in order to sell their output. For example, if I have a company of manufacturing tires, it may be car or tires, or it may be lorries, or it may be buses, etc. So in order to sell my output, I will make some expenditure. That expenditure I'll make on advertisement. My advertisement I can do either with the help of newspapers, I'll give ads on newspaper, or electronic media, that is on televisions, etc. I'll just ask them to make an advertisement for my company. Then a sales representative, you might have seen some kind of salesmen will be knocking your doors and they'll be trying to sell the product. So that is also one kind of advertisement. The fourth one is free samples, brochures, pamphlets will be given. So these are the various ways of advertisement, either through newspaper or through electronic media or through sales representative or through free samples. So why do we do all these advertisements? In order to promote our sales, in order to sell the output and earn profits. So this is what unit number 5, market, have these very short concepts. Out of these, you are going to get any one in your exam. Hope you have understood everything. Please note down all the points, write it 4-5 times, learn as many times as possible until you are perfect. See you in my next class with some more and interesting topics. Till that, stay home, stay safe, and always keep practicing.